Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot, and tonight we are going to play Zoo Tycoon Ultimate Animal Collection. This just came out today. It's available via the Microsoft Store if you want to play it on your PC, and it's available on the Xbox One Store as well. For those who missed sort of the announcements of this, etc., it is basically the same game that we had a few years ago that originally came out on the Xbox One, but it's now out on PC. It's now got nearly double the amount of animal species, some really, really cool animal species that you guys are going to love, I promise. Much more variety than in the past. It's got a bunch of new sort of single player campaign missions, and it's got some slightly increased customization. I'm going to show you guys all that as we go through the game. Because as you can see, we're just going to start a new game. If we go into training mode, you can see I've already done all the tutorials to kind of prep myself for this. We did play a lot of this game in the past, but it's been a while, and this is the first time we played it on PC. So what we're going to do today is do campaign mode, where the real zookeepers prove themselves, play through Fitchery, ladies and gentlemen, Fitchery, not 30, Fitchery. Fitchery scenario-based zoos in 6 categories. So we've got the original campaign that we've already done on the Xbox One. We may come back to that down the line. But for now, we're going to focus on the South America and Australia campaign. Now, both of these assume we know how to play the game. Be sure to play the original campaign first. Which I sort of did. It's just a long time ago. We're going to start with the South America campaign and Source America. Goals: adopt at least a jaguar, a cougar, a llama, an alpaca, a caiman, and a tapir. Keep the animals' happiness in the green and raise your zoo's fame. And for this, we get a few rewards. We get the next scenario. We get a gold tapir statue and a gold anteater fountain. We've got 20 minutes to do it in. This zoo lacks diversity. At least that is what your team told you after leading a customer satisfaction survey. Luckily, you are just back from vacation in South America, and thanks to the connections you made there, you may have just the thing to extend the zoo. But you'll need to act fast. Now, true story, I did try this a minute ago, kind of tried this video, and I kind of failed spectacularly. I kind of hit the time limit, but I've learned the error of my ways, and this time we're going to smash it, folks. So let's start the scenario and let's get going. The problem was, last time I did it, I kind of wanted to explain all the sort of new features as I went along, and I spent maybe a little bit too long explaining them. This time, you guys are going to see all the new stuff. I'm going to talk through it as we do it and kind of explain what's going on, but I'm also going to kind of try to move a little bit quicker than I was doing. So let's go. First things we want to do is we're going to go into our exhibits. So these are all the different exhibit types, different habitats, and we're going to research the medium-sized one. Basically, the bigger ones let you have more items in the exhibits, and they let you have more animals. That's going to be important in a little bit. So let's get that on the go. Challenges. Let's just go through this one by one for a start. Jaguar, cougar. Right, so let's build an exhibit for those two lovely creatures, which is, I believe, tropical. And we're just going to go for 2 small tropicals. I don't know if we can put them together without them eating each other. Oh, this is also new, by the way. You never used to have this much control over the paths. It isn't a big deal, really. It's definitely not the amount of control we'd want, but it's something. You can control which paths are in the zoo, basically. It's really not a big deal, but it's better than nothing. Let's put it that way. So let's set this up nicely so we can bring in a jaguar. Animal care, so we need a meat station. And we need a cleaning station. They're the 2 real types of animal care that you've got to include. And you also need enrichments to keep your animals happy. If I was a jaguar, I would want a scratching post, personally. There we go. And there's other things I need to get researching. Because I've done it before, I kind of know what I need to research. We do need to get to level 8 to get the tropical lawn. And we also need to get level 12, I believe, for the tropical pool. That's where we're going to get the caimans. Unfortunately, can't do either of those quite yet, so we can ignore this screen for now. Right, so we've got our exhibit set up. We've got entertainment, we've got cleaning, we've got food, and now we need to add some. Look, alpacas! Ah! The cougars, I think, yes. So the cougars require a little research, and we'll get that going right now. And what we'll do is we'll put jaguars in this exhibit. There they are, brand new jack. There's so many new animals, guys. I don't want to show you all of them yet. You know, we're gonna go through it over time. But there's so many, it's awesome. Sabrina and Nick. Good old Nick. Usually what you do is you bring in babies, but babies are super expensive. They're really good for your fame levels, but they're super expensive. So, oh, you know what, let's have a baby. Elwood, there we go. Good old Elwood. There we go, level 8, good stuff. Good stuff. So, because our puma is about to be finished as well, so tropical. Bring that in. Lovely stuff. Usually we'd spend a little bit more time on, say, making bigger exhibits, blah, 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 blah. I don't really like having small exhibits, but because we've got this kind of challenge, this timed challenge, we kind of need to poo, 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 you know? So, let's go meet our... We will have a little look at the animals at some point. Oh, look at Mandy. Mandy, you're too expensive. You're all pretty bloody expensive. Who's the cheapest? Right, Doris. Doris. And we need two of them. Actually, click on them. You can see the minimum social group for these creatures is two animals. And you can also see which sort of exhibit they prefer the most. So these, like the other ones, because these are South American pumas, in particular from, say, Chile and Argentina, they want a tropical kind of environment. So we're going to bring in Buttercup as well, because Buttercup is an amazing name for absolutely everything. Now that we've hit level 8, what we can do is go back into mini exhibits. Now, what these are, it's little exhibits that you don't really have much control over. You plop them down and you fill them with animals. You don't interact with the animals, you don't wash and feed them. They're good for like little small animals, you know, snakes and stuff like that. Or, in this case, tapirs. So, we're going to begin our research on the tropical lawn and we're going to build ourselves a nice big Andean plateau. Because the alpacas and the llamas can actually live together, so we may as well put them all in one big happy family. Am I making sense? Hopefully I'm making sense. Phew, right. There's also a new thing as well. I'll show you guys in a second. Oh, we'll do it now. Doris, the Southern South America puma, can't eat. Well, there is a feeding station. Did I not give them a feeding station? I didn't give them anything, did I? I'm sorry, guys. Sorry. Bear with me. There you go. Sorry. My bad. I just expected you to eat each other. It's not my fault, it's God. Again, scratch and post seems like a good idea for these guys. This is new as well, exhibit decorations. Not really a big thing, but just a little cool addition. Basically, if I can get to the one I want, there we go. It just lets you put in little decorations and stuff, just to give you a little bit more control of what your zoo looks like. It's like a little pile of rocks. Again, it's really not a big deal, but it's something. You know, it's little things. Level 9, we've got red-footed tortoise, lesser Antillean iguana, king quail, that's new, meerkats, katanga lion, large savanna, savanna rock, water, all this kind of jazz. Good stuff. I wonder if we should look at doing some research. Let's nip back over here. This is our main zoo bit. If we go into... What am I looking for here? Advertising. No. Oh, can I not do research? Oh, there it is. I'm wondering if there's any research that's going to help me bring in my fame, basically. There's a lot of stuff that we can do here that's like really entertaining, and we'll get into breeding, because you can end up breeding sort of unique colorations on all your animals and stuff like that, which is awesome, obviously. But it's not something for challenge mode. That's something we'll do towards the end when we're playing in sort of a more free-for-all. 10% more guests. I don't know how helpful that'll be. I'm not looking for guests, I'm looking for fame. Or like zoo quality, that's that middle one, that 9. And we'll leave that for now. Okay, so let's go work on this Andean plateau. Exhibit items. Because it's a little bigger, we can do a little bit more with this. So animal care, let's get a fruit feeding station. How many have we got? We've got enough, we can bring in two. Why not? Mix things up a little bit. You want some fruit, you want some veggies. You gotta get all your vitamins, folks. Get all your vitamins. Don't know what I'm on about. Let's get ourselves a moose. Why the hell not? And a nice enrichment. If you... I think shelter. I think they need a shelter. Can I put in an interaction? I think if we get rid of one of the animal cares, we might be able to. Let's have a little look. There we go. Awesome. So this is going to let us do things... Feeding interactions, hose interactions, sensory interactions. So you can either feed the animals, you can hose them down, or you can do this thing where they basically match your face. For these guys, I think feeding interaction makes more sense. So let's do that. Okay then. Good stuff. Good stuff. Let's bring in some animals. Alpacas. Sorry, alpaca. Again, money is already getting a little bit low, so we really are going to stay away from the babies. One baby was enough, unfortunately. Rudyard! That's an amazing name. Right, there we go. So we've got Rudyard and whatever the hell the other one was called, and now we need to go to our llamas. Get a couple of domestic llamas. We're gonna get Roxy. And we're gonna get... Who's the cheapest? Frankie. Roxy and Frankie. They sound like they'd be a couple, don't they? And I have no cash left. I am incredibly poor. Fantastic. But we've done 4 out of 6, so we can now do the tapirs, right? I think so. Mini exhibit. Tropical lawn. Let's stick that there. Boop. Okay, and if we just go on to add animals, I think I might have to research the tapirs. Yes. Looking good though. Look at four different types of tapir. Bear's tapir, mountain tapir, Malayan tapir, and capybaras at the end. One of my favourite animals. The Surrey alpaca can't eat. There is food, is there? Look at it. Maybe it's the wrong type of food? Maybe they don't want fruit? I won't give you fruit. Let's give them some veggies. I'm so poor, and I'm still only rank 9. The problem I had last time when I was doing this, right, because we're kind of done now, to an extent. All we need to do is bring in the tapirs over here, and then bring in the caiman, right? Nice and simple. The problem is, because the caimans require, as far as I can tell, rank 12, I kind of had this point where I was just kind of scrambling to hit rank 12 in time, and frankly, I just didn't get there, so hopefully this time we're going to be okay. Let's bring in some tapirs. Minimum social group. That's all we're looking for here. Oh, but he's called Bufort. Can't not have Bufort. We need two of them. I think that's all we can get anyway. Bufort and Ebony. There we go. That should get us to rank 10 at least. You bloody hope so. No? Maybe? Hey guys! How cool is it? There's something crazy. Why can't I aim? There we go. I really wish they let you look into the exhibit properly. It's the only thing I wish they did. It's so fluffy though. Look at the fluffiness. Why are you facing away? You're all facing... Oh. I can't really do anything right now, so... Kind of wait until my cash goes up. Little tapirs, little Bufort. It doesn't really seem to have eyes. Just kind of like a hole in its face, but whatever. Little Bufort. We'll look at our other animals in a bit. One thing I think we need to do, so I'll show you this as well. What you can do is ping how happy your animals are. So all our happiness is in the green. That's really good because we need that to actually win the challenge. So the game crashed, like it did last time I played it. Basically, sometimes when you rotate quickly and your mouse goes off the screen, the game just seemingly can't handle it. So I'm going to try to stop doing it. I don't know what's going on there. It basically makes a big ass explosion noise. And things go mental. Thankfully, the game auto-saves pretty much every time you do anything. So we are okay. There we go, there's our rank 10. Look at the possums! How awesome's that? A little sloth, mongoose. Awesome stuff. Oh, and a level. Flying up, folks, flying up! Capybaras and anacondas, magpie, goose. Good stuff. Right, we need to get up from 11 to 12 then in the next 10 minutes. That is our goal. This is much better than I was doing last time. So what we want to do is we want to change our pings a little bit in the bottom right, as you can see. And we're going to see how... Right, our guests aren't that entertained. It's not very tidy. And they all need the restroom. So, there's just some good things to start things off. I think what we need to bring in is a janitor. I'm going to bring in a janitor. And we're going to build a couple of restrooms as well. I love how this is like this crowd cheering in the background. Woohoo! Adequate toilets! Yeah, baby. Alright, so that should help with that. Janitor's office is coming again. The problem I really have is that I'm poor as balls. The baby was a mistake. The baby's adorable, I'm sure, over here, right? But it was expensive. Right, there's something really weird going on with my mouse in this game. Where's the baby? Is this the wrong one for the baby? Why does this game hate my mouse? Just work, you little mongoose. Ah! Didn't mean to do that. There we go. Please turn around, I want to see how fluffy your face is. Is that the baby? No, that's a pile of rocks, BestInSlot. Okay. Let's be in the other exhibit. Where's the other exhibit? Ah, it's over here. Look at the baby! Oh yeah. I mean, you're not the baby, but I just wanted to look at you, okay? There's actually a little challenge where you got to photograph every species in the game, so... Look at it! It's awesome! Good stuff. And the baby. Adorable. Absolutely adorable. I'm keeping that photo. That's a brilliant photo. Now save forever. Good stuff. Scratching away. One thing that really bugs me is that you still can't do this. You still can't go into your exhibits. I really wish you could. And I don't see why you can't, but... Ah, whatever. It's not that big a deal. I'm going to rotate very slow. There we go. There we go. No problems. Okay, so we're not really flying up towards 12 in time. We're actually not going to make it at this rate. So what I think we're going to do... We need to get a janitor in, because the place is bloody filthy, right? Let's just dump this over here at the side. I think what we're going to do is bring in some mini exhibits, and hopefully that's going to be enough to raise it up. You raise me up! So let's get the cheapest staff member, Matthew or John. I know, we've got a whole Jesus theme going on here. Matthew, get in there, son. I believe in you, lad. I believe in you. You can do it. Okay. About halfway. It's going to be on the cusp, because the problem is we need to research the exhibit itself, and probably the caimans. So really, we've got less time than it seems, basically. Let's research an arid pool. Got to do something, right? And let's get ourselves a tropical rock, and hopefully we can put something exciting in here and up our fame a little bit more. What have you got for me, rock? Iguanas. I want something I don't have to research. Agouti. We've never had an agouti before. Agoutis are brand new. Let's get some Azara's agouti. And we're going for the cheap ones, unfortunately. Magnolia, my lovely. We need two of them. Magnolia and Kevin. Oh my god, the other one was called Thunder. There's so many agoutis. As if there's this many agoutis. Look at that. That's a crazy number of agoutis. That's too many agoutis, I feel. I feel that's too... It's an offensive number of agoutis. Whatever. There we go. We're getting there. It's going up. We'll do an arid pool as well. That might be just enough to tip us over to 12. I mean, the cash is going up. I'm just not sure it's quite quick enough. We're going to need a little bit to research the one for the Cayman as well. I don't know. It's tough, this, guys. It really is. It doesn't seem like much, but there's a reason they tell you to do the main campaign first. I feel if you came into this straight from the tutorial, you'd kind of get your ass whooped. The fruit feeding station in this tropical small has run out of food. Okay, if we do that and that, we can go straight there. Awesome. Refill. There you go, lads. Don't worry about it. I'm going to go. I'm on poop duty now. There we go. Is everyone happy? Restroom should be no problem. Tidiness should start getting fixed. Animal variety should be good, yeah. They're not entertained. If I can bring in some entertainment, that might be enough to push this over the edge. But I think for entertainment, we need... I don't know what we need, actually. Entertainment, right. Okay, that's... We've already got one of those, so let's just bring in... I don't want that. Balloon shop. That's what we need. Balloon shop will save the day. There we go! Right, we've got to move. Right, we've got loads of cash for that because we hit fame 12. We've got 4.5 minutes. Let's go. This better be the right one. I'm not even 100% sure Tropical Pool is the right one. I'm just assuming it is because it's the only one that makes sense in my head for the Cayman. I really wish there was a way to check. And to be honest, there might well be a way to check. I just don't know what it is. Yes, it is Caymans. Oh, God, there is a way to check. I had no idea. I wonder if they go in any of the other ones. I'm so excited. Look at that. Owls. Owls. Numbats. I don't even know what a numbat is. There's some awesome new stuff. There really is. Really, really cool new stuff. I'm so excited. Less excited about things like magpie geese, but I accept that you need it. Water snakes. The thing is, in the original game, there was like 110 species of animal, right? But like 20 of them were a species of lion, and like 20 of them were a species of... elephant or something, maybe not 20, but you get what I mean. There was a load of creatures that were the same basic creature, but lots of variety. Now, obviously, that is still the case. You saw there, we have like 11 agoutis, right? But in general, it seems like there's a lot more variety overall, at least because, you know, it's whatever. I know what I mean. There we go. Hopefully the game's going to let me kind of play with the exhibit a little bit. I want to go look at our animals and stuff. But, don't know how it came. I'm so excited about this. How many types of caiman have we got? 5. Yakar. Right. We've got a little cash. We're going to get the cool ones. We're going to get Hercules. There we go. Where's my other statue? Where's my anteater statue? No, I didn't. I wanted to. Oh, did I hit the wrong button? Am I stupid? Can I like load my zoo back up? No. Oh, I want to look at my caimans. Game, no. That's totally my fault as well. God damn. Okay, well, that is the first part of our South American campaign. What we're going to do in the next episode, I think, is we're actually going to go over to the Australian campaign instead and do the first mission of this. I think that's a good way to, you know, keep things mixed up a little bit, view lots of different animals. And because I'm doing 2 episodes today, well, you guys can let me know in the next episode, what you guys want to see in part 3. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. If you did enjoy this video, hit that like button. It massively helps me out. It really does. And make sure you subscribe as well. Cheers. Much love. And as always... Bye-bye.